This is the University of the Netherlands lecture series by Rolf Hutt. In this lecture, I will demonstrate how you can make a weather measuring device using a garden hose. The original lecture was done in Dutch. This is the English dubbed version. There will not be perfect lip syncing. Also, the intro you're about to hear is in Dutch, but after that, we'll continue in English, so don't step away. Here we go.
Hoe kun je met een tuinslang het weer voorspellen? Dit is de Universiteit van Nederland.
One of the assignments I always give to my students is really simple. Build something that measures something. I don't care what it measures, as long as it's connected to water, still water management. But make something that measures in three levels, low, medium, high. You can use whatever you can find, but you cannot spend any money on it. And you get the most wonderful contraptions. You could use a parking aid sensor. You have to ask the owner of the sensor. You could measure water levels like we did today. I had two students that lived together in a fraternity house, and they in their house they got a turtle aquarium thing. Yeah, whatever. And they were always fighting, kind of prisoner's dilemma. Maybe another University of the Netherlands lecture is about that, but it was never cleaned. So they decided to make a pedometer. Pedo is Dutch for turtles. And what they did is they built something where they could measure the turbidity of the water in that aquarium with a little traffic light next to it. And when it hits red, then the water is so turbid that light doesn't pass through it anymore. They just use a 3-cent light-dependent resistor for that. Perfect. They got a really high mark. I did a lot of rain gauge development. There was another group that thought, if he does it, we can do it as well. He always used sound. We're going to use the same ticking sound, but differently. So what they used is a kind of sensor that if you touch it, it gives a signal. Kind of like your phone, but just one pixel. And then what they did is they had a spring and a little plate with a little pin pointing down right above the sensor. And then you can see it over here. And every time a drop hits it, it would just bend a little bit down. It would tick on the sensor and they could count the number of drops. And well, they needed all the electronics that we talked about in my previous lectures and all the mathematics that we talked about. So you need that to be able to come up with an idea like this. You got this kind of stuff at home. And yeah, but you, this is difficult. And so not everybody has this, but I found it lying around here in Club Air. So we're going to build the simplest measurement device ever. Something we've been building for centuries, by the way. Classical barometer, pressure sensor. Some duct tape, a Stanley knife, wine cork, garden hose. That's about all I need, I guess. This is a bit full, a little bit less water, something like that. So there's just a little bit of water under in the lowest part of this bend, which is ideal. Here, you again. Can you hold this again? Okay, good. Don't move. Then I'm going to use this Stanley mesh to cut this cork in some kind of pylon shape so I could jam it into that garden hose in a few moments. I may have told you in one of my lectures that I can make things working, but not pretty. This is a demonstration. This is going to work. It's not pretty. So this cork is going to be in one of the ends of the hose. Like this. Just jam it in very tightly because you want this to be airtight. Perfect. So I always call these kind of things a first order apparatus. It's just a test to see if stuff works. people behind the cameras thought that this was never going to work. But ta-da, here it is. So I needed a piece of wood because I just needed something to tie it to. It's a piece of duct tape. You've seen them before, barometers, and they're 100 years old with glass and nice tubings, but the principle is really easy. And, well, secretly, it's again a mass spring system. Not surprisingly, after the lectures that we've had here. So that should about do it. Well, so how does this work? There's a compartment of water here, and then because I put the cork in, this piece of air on this side is closed off. So the air pressure in here will stay the same. So if the air pressure on this side changes, it means that we'll be pushing harder on this side compared to that side, which means that the water level here would not be even. So if the air pressure lowers, it will move the other way around. So we pull it up a little bit. I could just blow in here. Oh, yeah, so you saw that moving, right? I could try to suck it out here. See? So this is just clear water, so it's hard to see for people at home. But I could just use some duct tape and mark where the water level is. So this is what it was today. And then if I put a piece of tape on there every day, I can measure how air pressure is changing. And I told you everything vibrates, and air vibrates at a lot of different frequencies. One of the fastest frequencies we can observe of air vibrations is sound. Thousands of vibrations per second. This system is not sensitive to sound. I mean, I can shout in it that it wouldn't change anything. And that's because it's, again, a mass spring system. So the sound wave is damped out in this part of the tube. So a barometer is, again, a mass spring system, and its cutoff frequency is very low. So it's ideal to measure very slow changes in air pressure. And those slow changes in air pressures we usually call weather. So if the air pressure is building up, it's a predictor that a high pressure area is coming towards us, meaning good weather is coming. And so if it's... These were the first measurement devices used to predict weather. It took me a few minutes to build this. You could do that at home with your kids or whatever in about the same time. And then you could measure weather. And if we think about the other lectures I gave, how can we make this electrical? Well, there's a lot of different options. What you could do is you could just put some nails in this and then make it watertight with some kit. And then have those nails go to a computer and then just measure one after the other. If it has electrical connection to a other nail that you put here on the lowest point. So then if it's connected with water, then you can measure that because water conducts electricity. And then just by counting how many nails are connected, you could see where the water level is. For example. Then yeah, I've got another electronic barometer. Wow. And because this mass spring system filters out all the high frequency noise, you can just measure once a day. I hope I showed you it's not really hard to make measuring equipment with the stuff you have at home. With a little knowledge, and I hope that today I gave you the first piece of that, and I mainly hope I gave you the enthusiasm that you can do this at home, so I hope you're going to go home and build your own devices. Thank you very much.